In this video, I'm going to help you try and become better at inspection so that you can plan out your cross and the first F2L pair in your inspection time. So after you solve your cross, generally the first F2L pair is the hardest one to find. And after you solve the first F2L pair, you tend to get more into a flow as more of the cube becomes solved and there are less places for unsolved pieces to be in. So then, if we're able to plan the cross and a first pair in inspection, this will help a lot, as look ahead will be easier if we only need to do it for the second pair. This is because if you solve more of the cube before trying to look ahead, it's marginally easier to do so. Planning out the entire cross and first F2L pair in inspection can be quite challenging, but world-class speed cubers would do it almost every solve. Here are some tips to help you practice planning out your cross and your first F2L pair in inspection. So the first tip I can give you is to use unlimited inspection and then just gradually reduce that. So literally just get a cube, memorize your cross solution, and then before you execute it, look for a corner and edge pair and figure out how they'll be affected by the moves you do to solve the cross and where they'll end up. And if it's too hard for you to visualize where these pieces will move just yet, don't worry, this will improve with practice, but you do need to put a lot of effort into this. So in this example, we would solve our cross, these four pieces, by doing R, L, F, D, L prime, D prime. And let's try and track where these two pieces will end up during that cross. So if we do an R, L, F, the R will move this corner piece over to here, and then L and F won't affect it because it's over here. And then when we do a D, L prime, D prime, the corner over here won't move at all. Again, if we do an R, L, F, this edge piece will move to here. If we do an L and then F, we'll move it to there, and then doing a D, L prime, D prime will not move this edge piece in this position at all. So this edge will end up here, and this corner will end up over here. So now that we know that, we can immediately go in and solve these two pieces after we solve the cross. And once you get even better at it, you'll be able to recognize in which orientation these two pieces will be, so that you don't even need to look at solving your first F2L pair. But just for now, we do an R, L, F, and these two pieces end up there, and the D, L prime, D prime doesn't affect the position of these pieces. And we can insert them straight away without even looking very much. When you do this sort of thing, you'll actually find that a lot of the F2L pairs that you try to track will either be extremely difficult or the pieces will end up in really bad positions. So it's not useful to track pieces and then find out that this corner piece ends up here and the edge piece is over here or something like that, because that won't be useful when you're solving your first F2L slot. Trying to track an edge piece that's over here and a corner piece that's down here is a recipe for disaster. So you really want to look for pieces that are connected to one another or in the top layer. So the challenge eventually becomes, you know, deciding which of the four F2L pairs that you want to track. And this is something I do intuitively and I've learned and practiced over many years. And it's still quite difficult to figure out, you know, when you're planning your cross solution, exactly which F2L pieces you want to track, because you only have so much time to actually track them. When you're trying to track a first pair, it's useful to lean towards pieces, for example, these two that are actually connected together and will move around together as you solve your cross. So for example, this cross solution is U prime, R prime, F, D prime, R2, because this edge is here, this one's here, and this one's here, and the last one is over here. So U prime, R prime, F, D2, R2. The only time that these two pieces will be affected is when we do the U prime at the start, and then they won't move from this position. And because they're connected, we know that, you know, they'll stay connected over there. So it's useful to lean towards pieces and look for pieces that are connected together, or those which will move around together. It's also useful to look for corner and edge pieces that won't move around when you're doing your cross. So for example, these three piece positions over here won't move around if we're only using the right, the front, and the down layer. So if we're only using R, F, and D moves to solve our cross, then the pieces in these three positions, so this edge, and this corner, won't move around at all. So you know that they'll stay constant, and if your F2L pieces are up here, then they won't move. If you're only using, you know, your R, F, and D moves to solve your cross, they'll stay like that. The last thing that's very important is color neutrality. If you have a hard cross solution, then it's very, very difficult, bordering on impossible, to actually realistically plan an F2L pair during your inspection time. And being color neutral will enable you to take advantage of the easier crosses and look ahead better into your F2L. And that's why being F2L is very important at the end of the day, because it allows for much greater inspection into your first F2L pair. To start out and actually get used to this technique, I'd recommend trying to do it on scrambles where you have easy crosses. So scramble your cube, and if your cross is difficult, then maybe solve, you know, one or two cross edges first, and then inspect from there and try and plan the rest of the cross as well as your first F2L pair. And then once you get good at this, try and plan three cross pieces and an F2L pair, and then plan your entire cross solution and the first pair. As I said before, when you're starting out and actually working on this, you won't be able to do it all the time. So in the cases where you actually have a hard scramble, I'd recommend doing something like planning the cross and one corner piece. And then maybe whilst you're solving the cross, look for the corresponding edge piece. But don't stretch yourself too far and, you know, try and unrealistically plan an F2L pair when your cross is very difficult. Something that can be very disheartening is if you think you've planned out your cross and your first pair, and you go ahead and solve your cross and your pieces don't end up in the positions you expect them to, it can be quite confusing and cost you a lot of time. When you're starting out, you won't be very confident and you might be prone to making more mistakes. So I do suggest that for a little while, after you finish your cross and you think you've planned out your first F2L pair, just quickly double check the pieces are where you predicted them to be in inspection and then go ahead and solve them.